Hello everyone, welcome back to the weekly market updates. I am Shaurya Khatgawat. So this week, Indian markets have resumed their upward trend. After consolidating in a narrow range, finally the indexes have given a breakout and comfortably traded, and almost all the indices are near their all-time high. The Indian markets have rallied on the back of positive global cues, especially the US markets have performed very well. Due to the favorable economic data, once again, the hopes of interest rate cuts have been reinstated. Also, the efforts from global community and specifically by the US to subside the tensions and conflict in Middle East region has also generated the hopes of peace in the region with the forecast of stability. Going forward, market participants will closely watch and look for the cues in the speech of Fed Chief Jerome Powell at tonight's speech at Jackson Hole Symposium. This week, Nifty, after trading in a narrow range of 300 points from 24,100 to 24,500, finally it broke the resistance and comfortably traded above 24,500 levels and managed to close at the level of 24,800 plus and clocked the gains of almost 1% on the week-on-week basis. Now, Nifty is only 200 points away from its all-time high, whereas Bank Nifty, being the laggard, is still 3,000 points short from its all-time high. In consonance with the performance of the previous week, the broader index, small cap and mid cap have again outperformed all the indices and they have clocked 2% and 4% of gains respectively on the week-on-week basis. सेक्टरवाइज परफॉर्मेंस में इस हफ्ते जो सेक्टर सबसे ज्यादा आउट परफॉर्म किया वो है आईटी, जिसने वीक ऑन वीक बेसिस पे मोर देन 5% के गेंस क्लॉक किए। नंबर दो पे रहा कंज्यूमर ड्यूरेबल्स विद क्लोज टू 5% गेंस ऑन द वीक ऑन वीक बेसिस। जिस सेक्टर ने इस वीक नेगेटिव रिटर्न्स पोस्ट किए वो है कंस्ट्रक्शन, विच हैज पोस्टेड नेगेटिव रिटर्न्स ऑफ ऑलमोस्ट 1% ऑन वीक ऑन वीक बेसिस। As the trend continues from the previous week, this week also FIs have sold almost 2700 crore rupees of stocks in the cash market, whereas DIIs have overcompensated and bought more than 12,000 crore rupees of stocks in cash market. Although a significant amount has gone into bulk and block deals, but nonetheless, money is money. Throughout the week, US markets have rallied and continued their upward trajectory. However, before entering into an important event, the speech of Jerome Powell, the market participants have decided to take off some profits off the table and decided to go with the lighter positions. Week on week basis pe Dow Jones aur Nasdaq dono hi flat note pe band hote hue nazar aaye. Wahi DAX Germany pichle hafte ke muqable is hafte 1.36% ke gains ke sath band hua. US job gains data for the 12 months ending at March 2024 has been downward revised to 8.18 lakhs, and that clearly indicates that job gains for the year have remained less than the expected number and thus supports the data for cooling down of inflation. वहीं स्वीडन के सेंट्रल बैंक ने अपने इंटरेस्ट रेट कट्स को 3.75 से काटकर 3.5% कर दिया है. All the important commodities in international and domestic markets both have shown a mixed trend, as gold was almost flat for the week, whereas Brent crude oil is 3.78% down for the week. वहीं सिल्वर ने इस हफ्ते 1.8% के गेंस दर्ज किए। Brent crude oil की prices में आई ये गिरावट का कारण mostly रहा चाइना से आई slow demand because of poor economic data and easing tension in the Middle East. India's second nuclear power reactor of 700 megawatt at Kakrapar, Gujarat has started operations with full capacity. Reliance Jio ने एक बार फिर से जून माह में सबसे अधिक सब्सक्राइबर ऐड किए, जो कि 19 लाख रहे, और उसके बाद Airtel ने नंबर दो पे 12.5 लाख सब्सक्राइबर ऐड किए। वहीं Vodafone Idea ने एक बार फिर से 8.5 लाख के आसपास सब्सक्राइबर लूज किए। Zomato ने Paytm का मूवी टिकटिंग और इवेंट बिजनेस को एक्वायर किया है 2048 करोड़ रुपए में। L&T has again bagged a big order of 2,500 crores to 5,000 crore rupees from Maharashtra government to make bridges and roads. वहीं IndusInd Bank को RBI से green light मिल गई है अपनी subsidiary asset management company setup करने के लिए, so that they can start their mutual fund business. FSN e-commerce यानी Nykaa ने बहुत ही strong set of numbers post किए अपने इस quarter results में, जहां उनका net profit year on year basis पे 150% बढ़कर आया है। This is it for this week. We'll come up with such more important information next week. Till that time, stay tuned with us. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.